So I'm Mark Lee Alexander, and thanks so much for being here today. We are about to have our Philadelphia walk. We're calling it Traveling to Love. We're starting at Jefferson Lupert Plaza with a whole bunch of people here from ADAPT, from the Philly Pride Day, from Jefferson, and whoever came from out in the community, and from Canada to Key West. We are working to walk and start Day for Tomorrow, and the goal is to have Day for Tomorrow be a parallel to Earth Day or People Day, because we don't really take enough attention or pay enough attention to people with disabilities in terms of disasters and extreme weather and also climate change. So that's our goal, is to bring attention to this important cause.
Emergency Preparedness Month. Disasters are across our country and across our nation, around the globe, all year round in the last few years, if you've been following a little bit the news. The United Nations says persons with disabilities are two out of four times more likely to die in a disaster. If people go in a disaster, when you're in it, even if you didn't have a disability, you've now been through a traumatic experience. Your family that may not be near you, they are suffering by your experience in through the disaster. And most recently, Hurricane Dorian has impacted America in a way that no other storm has before. First, it began through the British Islands and affected the Virgin Islands and Puerto Rico to an extent. The fear that these communities had from their trauma 2 years ago after Hurricane Maria and Irma is devastating. And they experienced mudslides and power outages. Thankfully, there the systems have strengthened since, and the response was much quicker than it was 2 years ago. Now Hurricane Dorian thrashing the northern Bahama Islands, mainly Abaco and Grand Bahama. We're talking about at least 70,000 people right now without any help from anybody. You hear on the news just now how the quote coming out is, it's reminding the reporters of the smell that they experienced during the genocide in Rwanda and in Haiti after the earthquake. We need help to go, and that's what we need to profound. But today we are here to introduce our colleague, Marka Lee Alexander. She has started a march to bring salience to make awareness that persons with disabilities are disproportionately impacted now in our age of climate change.
And thanks to Philadelphia for allowing us to stay at this beautiful Love Park here and walk here from TJU, where I was a student years ago. Thanks to Herman for setting everything up. Vicky and Shailen and people from ADAPT for being
Yay!
Here.
Yay!
Yay! People from Jefferson and Steve Williams and Dan Graves, who is our chief supporter, and everyone else that's here. And mostly thank you to my dear, sweet husband who's sitting there filming. Craig, you've got to stand up. Craig has actually walked with me along the way, or for me along the way. And also thanks to my son, Jagger, who's over here helping. Without a future, I don't know that we would all care as much as we all do care. And you know, our families and our friends are our future. And I've been working in rehab for 35 years, and one of the things that's very important to me is making sure that I'm spending my life in the way that I can do the most I can do. And right now, I actually quit my job to work on climate change and the issue of disability and disasters and disabilities. And we've walked here from Canada. You can see our walk on CanadaToKeyWest.org. We've actually walked down streets with and without sidewalks. One of the reasons is that if you ever try to walk, or especially God forbidding, if you're in a wheelchair or if I was in a wheelchair, it's impossible. The United States is not accessible. Okay. The United States is not accessible. The roads were built for cars and not for people. And that's why the only place you see sidewalks between Canada and Philadelphia, in all the places I've gone, has been in cities. And then if you're not in a city, it's in front of what? An institution where you can spend money. So there's a sidewalk briefly where there's stores, and then there's no sidewalks. So Craig and I have walked on roads that are pretty dangerous. We've walked over the Jersey Turnpike. We've walked not across it, but over it. We've walked in front of the Holland Tunnel and all around from Canada to here, really, and that's what we found in terms of sidewalks. But we've been trying to find people with disabilities that are out in the community. And between Canada and Atlantic City, we only found 11 people. So that tells me that we're not accessible out there. It also tells me that the weather and the heat are getting to people now, because we've been in temperatures that are 95, 98. The highest we got in a reading was 108 in Boston. And that's going to be happening here again this week. It's going to be 95 or whatever high temperatures this week coming up in Philly. So this is something that's here. Now, we've just been through a tough month. We've all heard about Dorian nonstop. No matter where we are, we've seen Dorian on the weather, and we see how Dorian has impacted the Bahamas and impacted Florida, probably only because they did hurricane drills in the southern part. And then it just finally landed in Nova Scotia. So we're here to talk about disasters and disability and climate change, and that's what I want to bring attention to. 1 in 4 people in the United States has a disability, and we need to bring this up, and we need to let people know that disasters really do impact people with disabilities more than anyone else. And it doesn't just mean if the disaster has happened. It means the preparation for the disaster. It means leaving your home. Leaving your home is much more difficult if you have a mobility impairment or if you need help than it is if you are able-bodied. So if you've got to leave your home for a week in preparation for a hurricane that doesn't come, that's also a trauma. So one of the things is that we talk about disasters and disability. The other thing we have to speak up about, though, now is climate change and disability. There was a town hall this week, and if anybody heard the town hall, issues came up about everything, but the issue of disability and climate change wasn't mentioned. So to the people that are here, I really would like to inspire you to start bringing this up. We've got to start talking about disability and disasters, but also and climate change, because climate change is obviously making the frequency of disasters worse. And the other thing we need to bring up is that this is a human rights issue. And in fact, the good news is that the United Nations has just put together a working group. They're just in the opening stages of having a working group for human rights on disasters and disabilities. Climate change and disabilities, I apologize. But that's important. We've got to move forward and we've got to speak up. Finally, how do we speak up? Well, one of the things that we're working to start is Day for Tomorrow. And this is what I want everyone to see. We need an equivalent to Earth Day. We need People Day now, because the Earth is going to be here. People know what Earth Day is, but the Earth is going to be here. The Earth may be inhabitable. It may be not a good place to live, and we know that because we're in the midst of the sixth mass extinction. So Day for Tomorrow is a day for us to be in community. It's a day that we propose that you go out and you meet your neighbors next door. Why do we want to meet our neighbors? Because if there is a disaster, if there is a event that happens, you need to know who your neighbor is and you need to know what issues they may have. Do they have mobility issues? Do they have other needs that need to be addressed? Do they have self-care needs? So we need to be in community. And Philly is supposed to be a city of brotherly love, right? And community. So where best to have Day for Tomorrow but in Philadelphia? So I hope all of you will think about Day for Tomorrow, will do something on that day, will actually knock on your neighbor's door, will consider having a Day for Tomorrow event. And we are going to be in DC that day on the mall between 3rd and 4th Avenue. So I hope you come visit us at that time. But what I want to hear about is this year's Day for Tomorrow event in Philly, but also next year's. I want to know what Philly does next year for Day for Tomorrow and how we bring this issue of community, disasters, disability, everyone getting together to support the future. That's about what I have to say. Are there any other speakers? Come on.
Hi. Thank you all for coming out. It's a beautiful day. And we're all getting, I know Philly is getting psyched up for the Eagles game. But before that, I think we really need to look at, you know, emergency preparedness for people with disabilities. We don't always think that that will affect us, but it affects our brothers, our sisters, our families everywhere. And one day, it will be here. You know, there are all types of disasters that can happen. And we need to be prepared. And we need to start raising our voices and letting people know that this is serious. This is something that needs to be done, and we need to be proactive about it. I love the fact that we're going to be doing a Day for Tomorrow. I think it's the right message. I think it's the powerful promise that we're looking at people and thinking about what's going to go on for tomorrow. And I just think that it's something that we all should be thinking about. We should all be talking about making sure that you go out into the communities, making sure that you're going. When you go to town halls and you're getting to speak to somebody that can, you know, just talk to everybody about it. That's the way that we keep creating more and more awareness to it. I, as most of you know, I'm from Disability Pride Philadelphia. And I was very happy to join in this today. Our mission is to create events and raise awareness for people with disabilities, and I'm just so happy that we could come out and do this. Also, my other hat is I am on the board of United Spinal Greater Philadelphia Chapter, and United Spinal National is a huge sponsor. We also want to thank Jefferson Health McGee Rehab,
yay!
Shriners Hospital for Children. I'm sorry, I'm going to lose my thought. We want to thank Disabled in Action. We want to thank Liberty Resources. Who else? Oh, I'm sorry, 365 Health Services. I knew I kept putting them in my mind and forgot all about them. And I also want to thank Planned Parenthood for providing us with waters and being a part of this event. Again, I think it's so important that we are talking about this, and that with what we've seen over the last couple years, this needs to happen now. We need to be working on this. We need to be having a plan, and you need to be checking on your neighbors when things happen.
And the next person we're going to introduce here is Dr. Steve Williams, who's a dean of the College of Health Professions at Jefferson, and he just wants to say a few words.
Hi everyone, thanks so much for being here. I'll make this short and sweet. I think that you've heard already that this is really a cry for a rally for us all. One of the things that we all need to remember is that all of us are affected by someone with a disability. Think about your mother, think about your father who has arthritis and has difficulty moving. Think about your grandmother who has dementia, who would have difficulty evacuating in a natural disaster. As we age in 20 years, those of us who are sitting here, and unfortunately, I think I'm closer to the aged than to some of the very youthful people up here, but we'll all experience some type of disability as we move forward. So this is an important day because it's a rally call. A rally call to change the world. A rally call to make us all more visible to government and to our cities and to each other, as has been said many times here, so that we take care of each other and that we're ready to face these natural disasters that seem to be coming quicker and harder as extreme weather events occur as a result of climate change. So thank you all for being here. Thank you for the walk. And as we move forward, let's remember that it's time for a rally call.
Wow, that's not normally what they tell me to do. So I'm going to tell you a story. A good friend of mine, Lex Frieden, I'm sure a few of you have heard that name before, was in Houston in 2001 during a storm called Allison. It wasn't even a hurricane, but it wiped out the city of Houston for several months. And during this time, he and his wife, who are both wheelchair bound, were stuck in their home. They couldn't get out, and the water started rising, and they're there with their aide, who had to actually drag them to the attic and then break a hole in the roof and get them out onto the roof by himself. And for someone like Lex Frieden, who is a co-author of the ADA and has such stature in the disability community, to be in such dire straits, I think, is a crime. And I think that we need to do a lot of preparation, a lot of education, and a lot of work to make sure that people with disabilities can get out in a hurricane. I have lived through 14 named storms, and 7 of those were hurricanes. 2 of them were Category 5s. And I can tell you that it took a toll on me, even in my youth, to get out and start taking care of what I needed to take care of after the storm. Just evacuating is a hard job. The preparation takes weeks if you're smart to get it started early. The issue is that when I go through a hurricane, my best friends are going to be things like frozen water bottles and chainsaws, but that's not going to help you much. And so, you know, we have to relearn how people with disabilities are going to be able to survive these events. And we need to have the planning and the preparation done in such a way that everyone is included in that process. So yes, this is a rally day. Yes, we have some work to do, and I'm glad to be on the team with all of you. So let's get something done. Raise our voices. Yeah.
Thank you so much. In Philly, I'm known more as an activist, getting arrested, blocking the street, organizing. I'm originally from Puerto Rico. I lived there until 2004 and lived through many counted hurricanes. 2 years ago, when Hurricane Maria impacted Puerto Rico, myself and my partner here from Shaylin were called upon to be first responders in Puerto Rico through an organization called Port Light. Thank you. We were there for 3 weeks right after the storm, empowered local disability-led organizations, was able to then expand their resources, capacitate them, and come back to Philly and continue working with them so they could provide services. It was seen more recently after Dorian Category 1 passed through Puerto Rico, they were able to evacuate people with disabilities early and get them back home quickly. Good response. Category 1. So from that, over the last year, working also with the Global Partnership for Inclusive Disaster Strategies, we are the one USA organization focused on disasters and persons with disabilities solely. We helped develop two federal pieces of legislation that our Senator Casey from Pennsylvania introduced. One of them is Ready for Disaster, which is also it's a bicameral bipartisan bill. It will allow more resources, economic resources, for nonprofits to be able to serve people in disasters that have to go through the red tape of FEMA and Red Cross. It will also create entities in the government to evaluate how badly the money's used for disasters. There's also the other bill is the Disaster Relief Medicaid Act, bipartisan, bicameral, federal bills that will essentially allow people that have or qualify for Medicaid, any Medicaid service, to be able to use that if they have to evacuate in a federal emergency declaration. So imagine if you are in Pennsylvania and you have to evacuate for whatever reason to Mississippi. Many of the services that our state provides are not over there. And Medicaid is not something that I can take with me across states. When DRMA passes, Medicaid will follow persons in disasters. With 2 years federal coverage for that state, for that individual, and full services that that person would have qualified in their state without the need for evaluation or paperwork or any of that crap, to tell you the truth. This will make a big change for those of us that use Medicaid. And Medicaid, let's remember that it also, for example, accounts for half of the coverage of pregnancies in the United States. And thank you, Planned Parenthood, for all you do. Now, globally, I was just almost ending up. It's getting a little hotter, and Martha will just give a closing words in a minute. I was most recently elected as it's a long title, but United Nations Disaster Risk Reduction Focal Point for Persons with Disabilities in the Americas. Essentially, it allows me advocacy powers to be able to, as a focal point, bring information from the grounds to the United Nations and from the United Nations down to the grounds for persons with disabilities in matters of disaster risk reduction across our big continents. In the United States, in Mexico, in Guatemala, in the Bahamas, talking about every country in the Americas. Now, with that, we have been started over 2 weeks ago having daily communications with our partners in all the areas affected by Dorian. We are having assistance across the United States border and opening communications with our friends in Canada to see how we can assist. I mean, last night, 500,000 people lost power all of a sudden. As Marco was saying, imagine if a child on a ventilator, I know my grandmother cannot sleep without her CPAP machine. It could hamper her living. So power dependency right now, if at the middle of the night you lose power, what do you do? And if you're disabled, it's that much more difficult because the systems around us are not accessible for us. United States has been going through fires in the West. Pine Ridge and the Midwest has not recovered from the bomb cyclone. And now Dorian has fully affected our eastern coast and our neighbors in the Bahamas. There are multiple weather cells forming that could bring more hurricanes in the next week. We implore you, please think preparedness, persons with disabilities, and disasters. If you have a chance, go please to the Canada Key West website and Facebook. Please also follow us on for information on the bills on our work on reaadi.org and forwardlight.org. Thank you.